We thought very long and hard about when the right time to do it would be. We started a transformation program 2 years ago, which was all about building up the two businesses even to be even better in the UK than they are today, and they're great businesses, and that's really worked. We've got a fantastic hotel group and a number one coffee business. We also knew, however, that those businesses both needed an international growth trajectory. And neither of them had that. And in the last 6 or 7 months, we have done two acquisitions. We've picked Germany as the market for Premier Inn that we think we can be successful in. And we've acquired a hotel group, which means we'll go from one hotel now in Germany, and in 2 years' time, we'll have over 30 hotels open in Germany. And we'll be a really big business. And that's a great platform when you're operating in great sites out of 15 cities to grow a business. And on the Costa side, they need an international growth agenda as well. We made an acquisition of half of our joint venture partner. So we bought them out in South China, which is everywhere except Beijing. And we've now developed a plan for China that will triple the number of stores that we're going to have in the next 2 or 3 years. So number one in the market in the UK, starting to see these proper growth trajectories internationally for both businesses.
So why are you doing this?
In the last 2 years, one of the big pieces of focus for us has been improving efficiency in the business. And we set ourselves a target 2 years ago to, over the 4 year period, to have £150 million of savings. We managed to deliver £105 million in the first 2 years. And so today we increased our efficiency target to £250 million. And because of the announcement of the demerger, we also said we're going to get £100 million of that in the next 2 years. And that's a way of making sure that as we do the efficiency savings, we embed them in each of the two businesses. So when they are independent, that they get all the shareholders get all the benefit of that inbuilt efficiency into them.
Obviously, you have a lot of buying power with these two businesses under one roof. Do you worry that they won't be as strong in that regard once they're separated?
There's a lot of work to separate, but the two-year time horizon is actually all about completing some of the transformation plan that leaves the two businesses in a much stronger position. So completing the IT transformation and the digital capability and getting more traction in the international growth of the business are all things which, when at the point of demerger, will allow both businesses to thrive much, much more easily. And it will give them a platform to really accelerate their growth thereafter. So the timescale is not just a demerger timescale, it's also a completion of the transformation.
Will this really take 2 years to disentangle these two businesses? That seems rather a long time.
It's hard to predict in 2 years' time. What we do know is that, and everybody has a different view, and everybody has a different sum of the parts. All the analysts all do their own work, and they all ascribe a value to individual companies. Certainly in the last couple of years, UK stocks have been quite subdued, as it's been a bit more uncertain in the UK, and certainly investors from other parts of the world are a bit more cautious about investing in solely UK stocks. And we have been a solely UK stock. And it's been one of the reasons why strategically getting an international growth and to diversify both companies is so important for each of them.
You have two very high profile activist investors on your shareholder register right now. Have they in any way forced your arm into doing this?
I think not on the demerge itself or the time scale in which we want to complete the transformation plan and path and then separate. But certainly I think they have influenced the debate being very vocal, and therefore the need for us to give clarity, and therefore the need for us to announce it. But what they haven't done is change the plan that was originally set to do this in about 2 years' time.
Now, in terms of the trading update, you mentioned that there are some very challenging conditions that you're facing here. Is that just in the UK or is it elsewhere?
It's actually because we're a mainly UK business. We feel it in the UK. The Premier Inn business and the hotel side of the business is doing well, and we're not seeing so much of the challenge or the lower confidence levels in either business or consumer. The key area it impacts us in Costa is on high streets, where the footfall in high streets, as you'll read from the BRC data or our retail friends, less footfall on the high street means less people going into coffee shops and having a coffee. So high streets are down about 4%, and consumers do feel, I think, a little bit more constrained. I think they're being quite careful in terms of how they're spending spending their money, and they haven't seen big growth in wages, but they've seen some of their inflationary cost pressures coming through into normal individuals' pockets. So I think they're being careful on what they spend and where they spend it, and they're spending a bit less time on the high street.